All right, now I'm going to give an example of how the law of attraction is applied to astrology. Now what we're going to listen to here is this man talk about Hermes and how he predicted the corporation control that we have today. Now keep in mind, Hermes was the top influential guy of his day. So, as Hermes spoke, so the rest of civilization followed after Hermes. Now, if Hermes speaks something that is bad to happen to come, well, then the universe is just going to attract to Hermes bad that he had predicted. So let's hear it.
Why do we even have a brain, a cerebrum, and a heart? So we've been conditioned, and the conditioning has taken thousands of years. And we're going to go into that today. We're going to go back to good old Egypt and Persia and Babylon, where things got corrupted. No one's fault. You can say it's no one's fault, or you can say it's everyone's fault. We're all involved in this fall from consciousness to the point where we don't even recognize universal mind thinking anymore. And we can't see the holy, in the Corpus Hermeticum, which is basically all the words of wisdom of Hermes. Hermes had a prophecy, and it's called the Lament of Hermes. See, thousands of years ago, Hermes foresaw the condition of mankind down the track, when we would go, because everything is in rhythm. You see, Hermes taught the seven principles of Hermetic principles in the Kybalion. One of those principles is rhythm. So, and every surfer will know that when he gets on top of the wave with his surfboard, he's going to get some momentum. Down here, there's nothing. Right? So he's looking for the top of the wave, the crest. And see, we've actually, when Hermes recorded his lament, he was up here and he saw the beautiful temples of Egypt, all commissioned, all working, all healing people. You could go there and you could be healed, you could have beautiful wisdom. And when we look at hieroglyphs, we go, what the hell is that? A bird, a hawk, an ibis head, a jackal? What are all these hieroglyphs? Well, they carry meaning. They're containers. That's what cartouche means.
Okay, so we got the gist of it recorded that I wanted to use for an example. Now, you notice that he started out in the video and he said that people have been conditioned for thousands of years. And then he goes on to talk about Hermes. And Hermes predicted the fall of the ancient astrology knowledge. Now, if Hermes would have fully understood the power of thought, he would not have wrote a book and distributed it to the people and got all the people thinking that doom and gloom was coming down the road. So you can see how the law of attraction is in effect here. As a man thinks, so does the universe attract to him. As a man speaks, so does the universe attract to him. As a man writes, so does the universe attract to him. So, Hermes, using the power of his influence that brought the people the ancient knowledge of the universe, he used his influence to bring all of mankind under his influence through prophecy. See how that works? So he wrote a book and distributed it to the people, and he said, we have everything wonderful and good right now with all this ancient knowledge we got. It's wonderful. But he said, also in the second vein, he said, but it's all going to be taken away from us. In other words, he predicted the brutal control of the corporation. So, we can assume that all the people followed his words and his advice, and they now set their and programmed their minds to this way of thinking, that the world was going to come under the control of brutal terrorism, and you can see it did come to pass. But I'm here to say, if Hermes would have utilized his full power of thought, he would not have written a doom and gloom book. And he would not have spoken it. And he would not have mentioned it at all. But if Hermes would have kept saying, peace and safety is always ours. Peace and safety is always ours. This ancient knowledge will always remain. If he would have said that, then everything would have influenced the people in that direction. And everyone would have put their thoughts and intentions on that. And everything, all the ancient knowledge, would have stayed and remained. So, now this man right here is very knowledgeable. His name is Santos Bonacci. And but I can tell by listening to Santos's videos, and I've listened to many of them, I can tell that he doesn't fully understand the power that our thoughts have. Our thoughts have the power of influencing all of creation, which includes the universe, all the stars. So we can change the atmosphere of the universe. We can change the orbits of planets. We can change everything, the consistency of planets. We can even change the natural universal laws to operate at even higher laws. You see, the only reason why we're stuck in these lower universal laws, which are even higher than legal codes, the only reason we're stuck in these universal laws, which is the law of the wave of vibration, the law of traveling of light, the only reason why we're stuck in those laws is because one man or if one small group of men kept promoting the same idea over and over and over. So they said, light moves in a wave over and over again. They said, the sun moves in a wave across the solstices and the equinox over and over, the same thing over and over again. The great teachers of history keep shaping our reality at a universal level by continually repeating the same universal laws over and over again. But I'm here to say that we can take it to the next level. And at the next level, anything's possible. We can bring 12 suns around the planet Earth if we want. So all we got to do is think it and then apply leaning and trust aspect to those thoughts and letting the universe reconfigure itself so that we can bring 12 suns around the earth and the earth can be continually heated and lighted 24 hours a day. All we have to do is thank the desire continually that all things are possible. And then we apply the trust aspect. And that's the idea that the thoughts of the universe will work on this new idea and reorganize the whole universe for our sakes, and it will reorganize it all automatically. Because the universe and the spirits in the universe will be feeding off of our thoughts, which says, you can do it, universe. All things are possible. You can do it, female. All things are possible. You can figure it out. You can do it. Female is just another way of saying stars, moons, and planets, cosmos, gases, dust, everything, space, everything that we see that's created. It's all female. And the female is influenced by the male through agreement by way of peace, safety. Now, the reason that I am able to reveal this higher level of information is because I have a security agreement and a claim of lien on the public record. Santos doesn't. In fact, Santos, in some of his videos, has gone into the courts without a lien, and they chewed him up and spit him out. When you become a secure party creditor, you don't even have to go into court. All you gotta do is send them a letter in the mail, even in the email. All you gotta do is send the court a letter in the email. You don't even have to waste money on a stamp. Just use the free email and give them the link to where your security agreement commercial lien is posted. And they know that they have to abide by that agreement. Although they will test you. And the only reason they will test you is because the universe is the one that is actually testing us. So if you can get it straight in your in our minds, if we can get it straight in our minds that no man is out there testing us, even though it appears as though men are testing us, it's the universe that's testing us. We are here in existence to pass the test of the universe, not the test of man. Man is just being used by the universe as a minister of testing. So once that information sinks in us and it becomes conscious all the time, then that will be the guiding strength to where we will quit yelling at everyone, yelling at the courts, yelling at the cops, yelling at the bill collectors. We'll quit pointing the finger at them. We'll quit all this harsh language. And this will happen because I'm saying it will happen. I am the Hermes of today's day and age time. All the multi-trillions of spirits, they speak through this voice. So, I figure I'd just get that on the record. Talk to you later.